The following podcast has been rated listener MA. It contains strong language, violence, adult situations, nudity. Listener discretion is advised.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back to the Laughing on the Sidelines podcast. I'm your host. My name is Scotty Gurman, a.k.a. Scooter McFuckstick, and alongside me, as usual, I have two excellent stand-up comedians. First, the 1984 Kingman County T-Ball Defensive Player of the Year Award winner, Mr. Jeremy Joseph.
Sup?
Sup, Jeremy? How's it going, buddy?
Great.
Awesome.
I'm just keeping the loose today.
Okay, all right. You sound energetic.
I'm fucking mellow. That's what I am. I bring the mellowness. I like to bring it down.
Okay.
Last week was high energy.
Okay.
This week, we're going to bring it down.
Okay. All right. And also...
So, at the risk of sounding redundant, sup?
And also, the wreck himself, Mr. Derek Alders.
What's up, Laser?
What, Laser? I'll take that nickname all day long, bro.
You told me that's what everybody called you.
No. Nobody's ever called me Laser.
That's what you were nicknaming yourself?
No, Blazer.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because you wear stupid fucking jackets all the time? Is that why?
No, that's not it.
Or is it because you're a pyromaniac?
Yeah, that.
So you just set fire.
No, I'm a trailblazer.
If there was one piece of clothing that really identified Scotty, I'd say it's a sensible pantsuit.
It's a sensible pantsuit nice. Podcast.
So. Yeah, mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, everybody, welcome in. If this is your first time listening to this show, this is a pantsuit
podcast.
This is a podcast where we like to talk or make inappropriate jokes about the current events that are going on in sports and inappropriate jokes that have nothing to do with sports whatsoever. This is also an adult podcast where we like to, cuss a lot, make loud noises. So if that's not your thing, then you are in the wrong place. Get the fuck out of here.
Mm-hmm. What about, can we make inappropriate jokes about things from historical sports?
Sure.
Because today, I don't know if you noticed this, today, March the 2nd, it's Tuesday. Tomorrow, it won't be today. Today is the 59th anniversary of Wilt Chamberlain scoring 100 points in a game.
Yeah? All right.
So go away. Jokes. Come on. Get on with it. Inappropriate.
Yeah. All right. Well, this is a show. We got a lot to go over, but not a lot of sports because this is the dead time for sports anyways. We got some week recapping that we need to do. We got some NCAA basketball. Baseball has started and some transactions going on in the NFL and preguntas and another draft. But as always, let's start off with our week recap. We like to talk about what happened to us over the last week. And Jeremy.
Yeah.
Sup, dude?
Sup.
Yeah.
let's see. Well, last week I watched NASA as they landed a rover on Mars.
Yeah.
Fucking nerd. I didn't watch them land the rover. You can't actually see that part. I watched NASA. I watched them cheer. Inexplicably for something they've done several times before.
Right.
Well, that is the red planet.
That, yeah. It sure
and
is.
They landed a rover, so who are they going to send right on over?
Oh, boy.
Martians.
Yeah, they can't send that fucking Curiosity. It's dead.
Yeah. Challenger can't do that.
Yeah, this is the Perseverance.
Gone. Yeah.
It's just going to be like, I'm going to fucking wait here till somebody comes over. I am Perseverance.
I heard that thing is literally the size of an SUV.
Yes.
It's fucking big.
It's big. It's pretty lightweight for something that big. But what's really cool about this one, it's because there is a slight atmosphere on Mars, it's got a fucking drone helicopter that it can fly and then it'll return to it.
Oh.
So it can like get places that no other rovers have gotten to before. It's actually very cool.
Damn.
We're
going to discover some shit.
So they spent, close to $1 billion to find out. No, there's nothing living up there still. Still nothing up there. Still nothing. Let's see. I started a new project in my wood shop.
No kidding.
Uh-huh.
Bore us with that shit.
I was so fucking... I had grown so sedentary at home. I needed something to do.
Okay.
And my wife's like, I want something to display my shot glasses. Fucking drunk. now, she's been to basically every Hard Rock Hotel or Hard Rock Cafe in the world, and she gets those double shot glasses.
Oh, yeah.
And she's got roughly 1 million of them. I lost count after 8. But There's a bunch.
Your wife has a bunch of knickknacks.
My wife is, I've described her as an organized hoarder.
Yeah?
She has a lot of anything that she keeps, but she is so meticulous that everything is neatly organized and cataloged and all that shit.
Yeah, she's smart. And she's smart.
Yeah, no.
math?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
Very good at that.
Okay. All right. Making sure.
Let's see. What else? Just one thing, a note that I'd like to make. Coming to your house, I think I made this same remark back in late fall time, too.
Mm-hmm.
I leave my house about 6 o'clock to get here, and that is a great time of day to come west. Wow, just staring right into that fucking sun. For people who have just don't appreciate the sun, take a few minutes and just stare at that fucker every day, just so you can really appreciate it, because that's what I had to do to get here. God damn.
Nice.
Uh-huh.
All right.
That was my week.
All right. How about you, Derek?
Well, I drank a lot.
Yeah.
Surprise.
No.
I did, some people may know, I bought a firearm last year.
Yeah.
And I've never shot it. So I finally went out Sunday and shot my gun.
Fuck, bro.
What'd you shoot it with?
I shot my gun. I also got free gas and $327. And if anybody asks, I was with you on Sunday between the hours of 6 and 8 p.m.
Got it.
So
nailed it. When you started talking about the gun, I thought you were going to pull it out and shoot me.
Oh, no.
I really did.
Jesus. Not on air. I'll get caught.
Oh, okay. After the show.
Yeah.
Well, this isn't live streaming.
Yeah.
We can go and edit that out. We need Scotty for that.
We need Mitch.
To show us how to do that.
So. Mitch is going to have to edit that out.
Yeah, Mitch. Get old
We're
going
to have to bring him back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep.
Shouldn't have fired him.
Right. So I shot my pistol, and then it was a good friend of mine's birthday yesterday. So we tried to throw him a little bit of a surprise party, but he showed up before everyone else did because that is the kind of guy he is when it comes to going to the bar.
It's a surprise for everybody else.
Yeah, everybody's like, what are you doing here?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's our buddy.
So
yeah,
that was my week for the most part.
I was there at that birthday party. This is my week. I'm first off, our buddy. Can I say his name? Or,
yeah.
No? Okay. So Jamie Deuce. I love that guy. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to him. We all go to a bar, and I saw something that I've never seen before, and I was so happy that I saw it. Derek has told me many, many times that his wife hates a particular song. And we were at the bar.
Is it the Hokey Pokey?
No.
Because that's what it's all about.
Maybe that too.
That's our foreplay.
Oh, okay.
Played that at our wedding.
Yeah. When I put my left foot in, holy shit.
Nothing gets her heated up.
Yeah. You got to take it. You
got to take shake it out. It all about.
Shake it all about.
It's nature's slipper.
Yeah. You shake it all about. You shake it all about with it in.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
You got to hit the DEFNG spots.
Yeah. Anyways, we've known for years that Derek has told us that his wife hates a very a particular song more than anything in the world, and she ends up going to the bathroom. And naturally, if you tell Derek that not to do something, chances are he's probably gonna fucking do it anyway. Especially if he knows it's gonna get a rise out of somebody. So sure enough, she goes into the bathroom, and Derek decides to put on the Never Gonna Give You Up, Never Gonna Let You Down song.
She hates that song.
She hates the Rick Rolled. She hates that song to the point where she came out of the bathroom and the fire in her eyes of wanting to beat the shit out of Derek was something that you would have thought that she found out in the bathroom that he'd been cheating on her for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
It was bad.
Yeah, she hadn't found that out yet.
Oddly enough, Derek did let her down. Yeah.
Ironic. I know, and I don't know why she hates that song. I mean, just like listen to the lyrics. They're actually pretty nice. It's kind of romantic.
Sure. And what's great is Rick Astley is actually a really cool guy.
Yeah.
And he has a great sense of humor about himself. He knows he's a fucking joke. And so he'll really go and ham it up anytime he performs live and shit. I've seen him on TV shows. He knows that he's a douche.
He performed that song on stage with the Foo Fighters.
Yeah.
That's fucking awesome.
Yeah, which my wife loves the Foo Fighters. So I was like, honey, look, the Foo Fighters.
That's so fucking
boom,
awesome.
Rick rolled.
That is so fucking great.
He actually does some really good covers of some other songs, none of which can I think of at the moment. So, yep.
The other thing was is I'm kind of a big nerd too, Jeremy. I wanted to ask you a question if you ever got into a particular show that I had to like kind of binge watch because I've missed the last 3 weeks in a row.
Mm-hmm.
BattleBots.
On paper, I should like it.
Yeah,
but no, I think just because the participants are such pricks.
Oh no,
I can't. And it eventually, it's like I've seen every configuration of weaponized little robot.
Fuck, I haven't. They're coming out with new shit.
They're remote control cars, and it's
not all of them.
Yeah,
anymore. They got some fucking crazy designs. There's one cunt with the one that like walks around and shit. It doesn't have any wheels. And so imagine the moving parts that's in that bastard.
Oh,
and
you Jesus, yes.
Just run.
It like walks upright?
Yeah. It has no joke, 16 legs that fucking move it around.
Okay. I was going to say, if it like walked on two, humans are some of the dumbest design creatures on the planet as far as ease of mobility. Being bipedal like we are, it's, yeah, stupid.
No, but I totally fucking nerded out on that. So,
yeah. To each his own.
Yeah, yeah. So
I like
that's my shout out to my nerd
show. I like to
think
that the Perseverance rover is just BattleBots on Mars.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Good call. Good call. The other thing that happened, it was a good thing for us last week. Whenever we were doing the show, we were sub 100,000 followers on TikTok.
Mm-hmm.
We broke through that motherfucker pretty easy.
So now we can quit.
We are done.
Thank you guys so much. Keep on laughing, assholes. Find another show.
It's our last show.
No, it's not. But I thought that was really cool. We're now up to 112. So guys, keep doing what you do. Share that shit. That and tag people in it. Apparently, that's what gets those posts going crazy. So keep doing that. But that was pretty much. That was it. That was my week. That's all I did.
Okay.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, but before we move on,
thing I forgot that I did. I remember a couple weeks ago I talked about going to the doctor for my shoulder impingement. I went back and the doctor says that it is totally healed. I disagree because it still hurts like a motherfucker, and he will not believe me. I've never asked for painkillers or anything. He's like, no, we did the MRI. We looked at it. It's everything that was causing your pain, that's healed up. Then why the fuck does it still hurt?
Exactly.
Son of a bitch. I know what I feel. And I started crying.
You'll get over it, he said.
Yeah.
You know it's good for shoulder pain. If you lick my butthole.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Well, it's not that bad of a pain.
There's
really,
there's some stem
cells. It's healed. Honestly. My doctor said so. Got to trust in that. He's got that degree.
I had a guy at work. We were talking about some vehicles that we had for sale that were marked down big time. And I said, you couldn't sell those to your family, right? And he goes, no, I sold my grandma one. And I was like, oh, my God. Is that the Ford Escape that your grandma takes me out for ice cream in after I fucked the shit out of her? And I got a very funny look and then a laugh. Uh-huh. And then I got off work, and about an hour after I got off work, I'm sitting at the bar, and I text him, and I said, this rocky road is the shit.
You don't fuck her in the Escape, do you?
Absolutely.
Really? That's,
yeah.
That's too small of an SUV to be fucking in, especially at your age.
Yeah. But anyways.
Well, then again, you don't have my shoulder problems.
Right. But before we move on to the sports part of this episode, I'd like to tell you guys about our awesome, awesome, kick-ass sponsor. Ball shavers.
Manscaped.com. Is that what they're called? Just ball shavers.
No. They keep you cleaned up, man. We got St. Patty's Day coming up.
I shaved a shamrock into mine.
Absolutely. Actually. Doing some designs, I think, just for the festive holidays, because this is the only one that all of us can get around. It's about drinking a lot of alcohol.
We need to get some stencils. You know what we should do? Is like, you remember whenever you were a kid and they shaved like lightning bolts into the side of your head?
Fuck, yes.
Yeah, I kind of want to do that on my balls
now.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Just a lightning bolt on each side of the old scrote.
Yep, get yourself a stencil.
You know what the best part about having this is? Anytime somebody says, hey, how are your balls? Better never. I can honestly tell them that.
Yeah,
they're not. You want to see?
Yeah, they're not getting tangled up or anything like that down there.
Mm-mm.
No, they're clean.
Yeah, they feel great. I've been showing pictures to people at work. I have a meeting with HR tomorrow, but they. I think it's just because he wants to see the picture too.
Probably.
Sure.
Yeah.
Absolutely, he does.
And you know what? Picture doesn't do it justice. Show them the real thing.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah,
I think so.
Just have them close the door behind you.
Mm-hmm. I've got an older iPhone, so it's got some pixels and stuff.
Sure.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Not good depth perception on those.
No. Mm-mm. No. Flip phone, you said?
No.
Oh.
Just an older iPhone.
I should get the flip phone. That helps. Helps with the appearance of the size.
iPhone doesn't make a flip phone, Scotty. Jesus.
Okay. But anyways.
But it's coming.
I hope so.
Mm-hmm. Manscaped.com is our sponsor of the show. They have a whole bunch of awesome products. Not only the Lawnmower 3.0. Mm-hmm. Excuse me.
Got some ball toner, some ball deodorant.
Ball deodorant is a thing you got to have, especially coming up with St. Patrick's Day.
Wait till the summer, folks. You're going to need that ball deodorant.
That's no
joke. You don't want to be fucking sitting there with shorts and just stench coming out of there.
Yeah.
Smells like bad decisions and feet.
Mm-hmm. I was kind of thinking.
Who's eating rotten egg salad? Oh, fuck, that's my balls. Won't happen if you put the ball deodorant on there.
Yep. Yeah. You got broccoli in your pocket? No. Actually, I don't.
I was actually trying to say that, you know, like with the festivities with St. Patrick's Day, I think that if you get the opportunity to drink as much alcohol and you pass out, I think it would be very, very appropriate if you know, when your friends are fucking with you and taking off your pants, or even if your girl is trying to, you know, forcibly rape you, that you should probably have that shit trimmed up in those particular patterns.
Look nice for your assailants.
Exactly. Absolutely. Yeah.
Exactly.
But anyways,
it's kind of like your mom always told you, put on clean underwear in case you get in an accident. Shave your balls in case you get diddled with.
Yeah.
In case you get roofied.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. But
I actually take the blade out of my manscaper and let my son practice.
Do you?
Yeah.
That's a new thing to do. Just because it feels good, the vibrations.
That way he feels like we're shaving together. Yeah. You know, that's...
Show them how to use that LED light in tight places.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah, and that LED will illuminate the entire situation.
Yes.
And you can take it in the shower. It won't rust up.
Nope.
No. Ceramic blade.
That's right. Yes.
Well, and, not in your son's, but
yeah. Yeah, I took it out.
And also, they also have the weed whacker, which I really do love that thing.
Isn't that thing fucking awesome?
Fucking awesome.
I don't like hair.
I don't like hair in my nose. Uh-uh. It bothers the fuck out of me.
I don't even like other people's hair in my nose.
Right. but they have tons of excellent products on manscaped.com. Do us a favor and use the promo code SIDELINES. Get 20% off your order and free shipping. That should help you guys as far as the price goes. But that helps us out a lot. That lets them know that we're doing our job with, you know, actually reading the scripts for all the commercials that they gave us.
Which we have never done. we hit some of the talking points. We have never read that script.
That's right. I just think it sounds like too dull to do it that way. Or two? No, that's
you sure not you wrong. Want to say that about our sponsor, Scotty?
No, I don't.
Because they're a razor company.
It's just not our style. We do it our own style, right. But we're still telling the truth.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the thing is, we wouldn't hype this fucker up if it wasn't as good as advertised. It is fantastic.
We actually have been getting offers from other things that want to sponsor us.
That really seems like off the air shit.
Yep. No, hold on. What I'm saying is though is that if it's something that we don't truly get behind, we're not going to do it
for a price. But
yeah, I'll fucking shove tampons up my nose for $1 million. I don't give a shit.
Puss corks.
Yeah. These Band-Aids taste great. You know, edible Band-Aids. Wave of the future.
Medical practice, actually, for people with like bad nosebleeds, they have cotton wads that they put up. They're called nose tampons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyways, check them out. Manscaped.com. Use the promo code SIDELINES.
It's easier to see with the nose tampon than the nose maxi pad.
When your face has its monthly.
Yeah.
We sincerely appreciate it. Okay. For the love of God, let's move on. Derek, how are you feeling about
it? Tell them about the discount.
Yes.
All right. 20%.
20%
free shipping.
Free shipping.
Side when you use the code SIDELINES.
Okay. Move on.
Let's talk about it some more.
No.
Again, that's SIDELINES. It's the code 20% off, free shipping.
We are at a loss for shit to talk about. We've got nothing.
No. Derek's got some shit to talk about because the Illini
put a fucking beat down on Michigan.
Jesus
fucking whoop their ass.
That's, I mean, it was embarrassing.
I loved it.
I know you did. That's why you were late.
Yeah.
Showing up late to shit.
Mm-hmm. And because I don't like you.
Well, that too. That's acceptable.
He goes out of his way to be rude and discourteous to you.
I park next to him just to door ding him. Yeah,
every time. Like, I don't care that it fucks up my car.
Yeah. Yeah. I didn't even need to go to the store. I just went to door ding him.
Wow. All key cars just because I thought maybe it's his.
And I moved a cart right behind his car, and then I left.
Those that people that do that shit are they are the worst human beings on the fucking planet.
Cart still had a kid in it.
Yeah, right.
Just so you'd get an even worse charge against you. Fuck up your car and a vehicular manslaughter.
Yeah, way to go. All right. Spectacular. All right. So, they put a stomp down on Michigan, which is the number two team in the country.
Mm-hmm. And we were number four, but I think we're going to go up a little bit after that one.
I probably. It was at Michigan, too. But doesn't matter. No fans in the stands. But
we got Ohio being a loss in the top three.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
We got an Ohio State game this weekend, too. So, two very tough games. And we actually won that game without Ayo Dosunmu, who is our best player and one of the best players in the country.
I don't
care. He's been out with a face injury. So, I don't know if he's going to be back for Big Ten tournament, but I hope he is.
Fucking ugly. Yeah.
Was it a piercing?
That's racist.
Yeah, it had a piercing. Yeah, fuck yeah, it was a piercing.
Infected piercing?
Yeah. No, it was at the end of the Michigan State game last Tuesday.
You got pierced. You shouldn't be getting your face pierced
during a game.
Other shit to focus on. That's not going to be sterile.
Yeah. He took an elbow to the face.
Oh,
that's what they're calling it now.
So
is that like a hoop or a stud?
It's actually a nose ring shaped like an elbow. It's weird. Nobody likes it.
No, absolutely not.
How do you guys feel about nose rings?
I don't like them.
I don't either.
Well, I'm for them.
Really?
Really?
Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't really care. But the only thing I can think of is if I had a nose ring and how absolutely uncomfortable it was. I obviously don't like hair up there. Why would I want a fucking stud?
Huh? You had one?
No, I can imagine. No, I can imagine.
He's got a belly button ring, though.
Those are okay.
Scotty has a belly button
ring. Those are fine.
My son's girlfriend in high school had like this little stud thing that went in there, but like with a little tiny opal, and every time it's just like you've got something right there on your it looked like a mole. It's like, what are you trying to do?
Yeah.
What are you trying to prove? Either get something big hanging out of there or don't do it at all.
Yeah.
Go big or go home.
All right.
I wish she'd just go home. She did, eventually.
There was some bad news over the weekend, though. KU handed Baylor their first loss of the fucking season.
I like how they win two games and they're like, all right, you're 13th now.
Yeah,
or whatever they are. Yeah, I think are they 17 or 13?
I think they're 13. They moved up pretty high.
I mean, beating them Baylor is a pretty fucking impressive thing.
Yeah, but almost losing to Iowa State or something like that. Yeah. I mean, come the fuck on. Show some consistency, you bitches.
Well, this is a season where there hasn't really been a whole lot of rhyme or reason or consistency to anything.
True.
But with them, it's unforgivable because it's them.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm just tired of them.
I mean, Baylor has looked like the legit number two team in the country all fucking year.
Number one team in the country. I'm sorry, but when Gonzaga has the strength of schedule that they have, I cannot honestly call them the number one team.
Did you call Wichita State the number one team?
Nope. Whenever we were undefeated at one point,
they never got number one, did they?
No, they were the number two team, which was correct. I'm sorry. It just makes more sense. Even though
apology accepted, Scotty.
Even though Syracuse was had a loss, and they wouldn't give Wichita State the number one, and I agreed with it. In fact, I thought number two was kind of being nice to that.
But here's the thing: is I've watched Gonzaga play like three times now, and yes, I realize that they're not playing good teams, but you can still see it. They're legit. They would kick the snot out of most fucking teams.
I agree, and they obviously really show. Good. They obviously show at the beginning of the season they get their strength of schedule, and you know they do that
right.
So I get that.
They've got some guys who are like 6'10" and higher that have point guard skill with the ball. They're really good.
Oh, don't get me wrong. They obviously recruit very well.
No, Scotty, they're really good.
I get it. Turn your mic towards you.
Why?
Because
tell me what to do with my fucking microphone.
You sound like a fucking you're down the hallway or some shit.
I was.
Oh,
spiritually.
Okay. Yeah. Anyways, you got anything else? Excuse me for basketball there, Jeremy. Your team,
K-State, beat Oklahoma.
Yeah.
Oklahoma was number 16. You talk about no rhyme or reason to anything.
Exactly. That
shouldn't fucking happen.
No, it really shouldn't.
No.
And then Oklahoma State last night ends up beating Oklahoma as well. So they may drop a little
bit. Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't actually watch the game. I've kind of given up on K-State, and I didn't have time.
Yeah. Well, it turns out that my team, Wichita State, hasn't played for like a week and a half.
Right.
Yeah. However,
well, after, can't lose that way.
Yeah, after beating and after the last episode we did, Wichita State ended up offering and giving Isaac Brown a 5-year contract.
That seems
kind of steep, isn't it?
Awfully committal for a guy who's only got one weird fucking season. Yeah, so I mean, what are they getting him for?
I mean, it's definitely not Greg Marshall money.
Well,
but,
no,
but
he's cheap. That's why.
Yeah.
And I guess, yeah, on a cheap contract, you can, if he doesn't pan out, you can always fire him and take the fucking hit.
Yeah, sure. I mean, but I still, I'm pumped for what he's done this season. I'm glad where we're at. But I'm thinking more of a 2-year contract would have been, I think you definitely give him the job, but I don't think 5-year contract
is very good. 5-year, $35,000 deal.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Okay. Moving on, let's get to some Major League Baseball. Mm-hmm. We got spring training in full swing.
The biggest cock tease of sports. That's, well, that or preseason NFL. Both of those are pretty bad.
Yeah, well, the thing with preseason NFL is you don't really see starters very much. And in baseball, you see them frequently. Like, they'll at least have one at-bat a game.
Mm-hmm. I would still love to go to a spring training. Like, I mean, I guess that's, players are almost totally accessible.
Mm-hmm. Well, not now. They're not.
Now
they're
But
yeah, you can
in any given year. Yeah, my wife's boss, who just retired after I want to say 85 years of service. He was there a long fucking time. He was over 80 years old and finally retired. He used to go down to Cardinals. He was based out of St. Louis.
Oh yeah.
He used to go down to Cardinals spring training every fucking year. Take a full month off and go down to Cardinal spring training.
That would be fucking
and
awesome.
And I was, even though I don't give a fuck about the Cardinals, I was always so jealous of him.
Yeah, because it's a winning team.
I beat his ass one night.
Because it's a winning team? Is that why you're jealous?
They're garbage.
No, apparently not.
Cardinals are trash.
Nope, Cubs are trash.
He got to spend a lot of time in Florida.
Oh, yeah, that would be, that'd be, yeah, I agree.
I learned, do you want to sidetrack from sports?
What do you got?
And a very interesting fact that I just learned yesterday about Florida.
Okay.
Cause you know how everybody makes the fucking joke? In fact, it's played out about how anytime there's any kind of a weird redneck trailer park crime,
Florida man.
It's always Florida. Mm-hmm. I found out why that is.
Why?
Florida has a law that no other state does, that all police reports are public knowledge to the press. Whereas every other state, it has to actually go to trial before the police report is is available to the press.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's it is all fucking police reports are available. So it's not that that shit doesn't happen anywhere else. The press just can't necessarily get to it.
Right.
And write stories about it.
And the press in Florida is like, this is some funny fucking shit. Mm-hmm. Let's blast it.
This is what we're known for. Might as well run with it.
Absolutely. You'll get some clicks for shit like that. But anyways, back to baseball. Did you guys see Gary Sanchez hit that home run a couple days ago?
You talking about the guy that was the producer of Step Brothers?
No, that's Dirty.
Gary Sanchez.
No, that's
the same guy.
Oh, is it?
You guys didn't know that? Yeah, he's trying out for the Yankees this year.
Way to go, Dirty Gary Sanchez.
This rookie's first at bat as a Yankee hits a towering center field home run. They have the batter's eye in center field.
Mm-hmm.
That is 40 feet tall. And I believe it's 408 feet to center field. He hit it over the fucking batter's eye.
And usually the batter's eye is behind the wall.
It is behind the wall.
So
by a good 5 feet.
That's
a pretty good.
That's what the Yankees need is another fucking power hitter.
Yeah.
Another guy who can go deep. Do
you know why that's there?
Why the batter's eye?
Yeah. Absolutely. And so because, you can see the baseball.
Yeah. They used to put fans back there.
Yeah.
And the ball would disguise in with them.
I learned this at Wrigley Field. I went on a tour there, and they said that before the batter's eye was there and there were seats there, they had a group of fans that would, like, wear black coats.
And then
whenever the other team was up to bat, they had just straight white T-shirts, and they just have their white T-shirts and stand there so they couldn't pick the ball up.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's cool, though. I mean, it's smart.
They also said that the reason that the baskets are there at Wrigley instead of like where the you'll see the ball land. Mm-hmm. No,
oh.
They used to have bleacher bums, one on the left field wall, one on the right field wall, and they would be, there would be somebody in the middle holding a pitcher of beer, and they would run across the top of the wall, and the first one that got to the lady with the beer got a free beer and got to chug it, and they would fall onto the field. So that's why they put the baskets down. Yeah.
That makes sense. They don't do that anymore?
No, don't do that no more. Damn. They don't even let you cup snake now. It's bullshit.
I always loved it at Kauffman whenever somebody would hit a home run, usually the other team, right, into the fountains out there, and a fan would jump into the fountain.
Yeah.
Not only are you getting arrested, but that's not a pool. That's there's all kinds of sharp apparatus and shit down in there that run those fountains that you're going to impale yourself on.
Absolutely.
And people just swan dive into that shit.
That's dumb. We didn't talk about this last week, so we're a little bit late to the party, but I have a question about this guy.
I'm going to refuse to answer.
Okay. Fernando Tatis Jr. signs a 14-year deal, $340 million contract.
Okay, I'll answer it.
With the Padres. Good investment, bad investment.
One of the few guys who's actually worth it.
Mm-hmm.
He's a fucking stud.
That's
any way that you look at it.
That's a clean sweep. All three of us agree.
I didn't even get an answer.
I just heard you say, we don't need to know. We didn't need to hear you talk anyway.
Okay, well, I'll see you later. Have a good night, guys. Keep laughing, assholes.
All right, bye.
In 5 years, the way that contracts work,
yeah,
you know, this might be a pretty low contract. So the fact that you could hook him in for 14 fucking years.
Oh, yeah.
And he's you know, basically you've made him your franchise player, is outstanding for them.
And they have a legitimate shot next year. I mean, they were in the playoffs. They did fairly well. They're just going to get better.
They added Yu Darvish.
Yep. They got Yu Darvish now, so they're strengthening their you know, rotation. I'm picking the Padres to be one of my teams later in the season, as long as everybody's healthy.
Obviously. Was Senior a player, too?
Who?
Tatis Senior.
Absolutely, but he played for the Cardinals. He didn't play for the Padres.
I didn't remember anything about him. Yeah, I don't even know when he played.
He wasn't any good.
He was good. I liked him.
Was he better looking than his kid?
No, they were.
Because he's an ugly motherfucker.
They are still ugly as fuck. Okay. That's it for baseball. We will
Ken Griffey Senior played, too.
Yeah.
Ken Griffey Senior.
He played on the same team.
Mm-hmm.
For a minute.
They hit back-to-back jacks one game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, God. Great. Come on, man. All right.
You didn't tell me anything I didn't fucking know.
Okay, well, whatever.
I actually saw Senior like play in his prime.
That's because you're old as shit.
So you don't got to tell me about him.
Yeah. It's all right.
However,
could you tell me, right?
Yes, linebacker for the Cowboys.
Speaking of linebackers, let's move on to the NFL. First things first, the Texans release veteran Josh McCown. Anybody surprised?
I didn't know he was in the league still. I thought they interviewed him for head coach, actually.
Was he hoping to compete for that starting job?
Maybe.
Because I don't think he was going to get it.
Well, why not? Because
they got a decent enough quarterback down there. That's all they got down there.
If Deshaun Watson leaves.
He ain't leaving. And you think McCown's going to be the guy to step in?
Maybe.
I think at this point I could do a better job.
I don't know. He's a lot more athletic, fast, you know, smarter. All those things.
Yeah, but I'm wiry.
Okay. That unfortunately,
I'm scrappy, Scotty. That's what I am.
I really like Josh McCown. I think he's an awesome dude. He's a troubadour. He's played for fucking 15 different teams.
Do you know what a troubadour is?
Yeah,
that's somebody who sings, Scotty.
he sings in the locker room, Jeremy. Rap music.
That's not singing, motherfucker.
No,
that's just talking.
No, like some Lil Wayne shit. You got the auto tune hooked up and everything. Leave him alone.
Jesus Christ. No wonder he wants to keep playing. He's got to pay for all that equipment.
Exactly.
Wonder if he wants to host a podcast.
Fuck you.
Oh, Jesus. How nice would that be to have a real NFLer instead of a douche?
Fuck you, Jeremy. All right. Next thing. The Bears.
Facts,
ooh,
dude.
Here you go. Here's Derek's favorite team. We got to pay attention here.
Mm-hmm.
The Bears add former Texas head coach Tom Herman to coaching staff as an offensive analyst. For what it's worth, the offensive analyst is a term or a position that they fucking made up. That's the
only
team.
I don't even know what that is.
Isn't that basically a scout?
They don't have an offensive coordinator because Matt Nagy likes to call the plays. They had Bill Lazor. Lazor, that's you.
Hey, that's me.
He was the offensive coordinator, but I think they started letting Matt Nagy was like, all right, well, now we're doing okay. I'm going to take the plays back over.
Yeah, it's just there's.
So they hired Tom Herman to sit up in the booth and talk into the fucking headset going, yeah, don't do that.
Yeah.
Don't, no. Mm-mm. In fact, the quarterback's headset goes right to him.
Yeah.
And they just let Nagy talk into his fucking microphone. It's not going to anybody.
Yeah. So what do you think, Derek? Do you think this is going to improve you? Improve your team at all?
No.
No. Come on. But he's from Texas. You don't mix with Texas.
You don't mix with Texas? Tex-Mex, motherfucker. That stuff's delicious.
Carlos O'Kelly's? Jesus.
Yeah.
That's the best of Irish Tex-Mex right there.
Chicken picado. It doesn't get any more Tex-Mex than that.
Mm-hmm. You know what? You know what Mexican restaurant I miss more than anything? Remember El Chico?
No.
El Chico?
El Chico.
No.
Yeah.
Where was that at?
Favorite. It was on like 21st and Rock.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I
miss Chi-Chi's.
Chi-Chi's was good.
Rio Bravo, never ate there, though.
I've been there before. I've been there.
There's a, God damn it, what is that place on South Seneca?
I don't fucking know. Taco Bell?
Taco Fajita?
No. It's got an even just more bland generic name than that. It's like Tacos Mexican or something like that. But it's like a really nice sit-down restaurant.
Well, hey, man.
Yeah.
Teach your own.
It's good.
Yeah.
But yeah, they're going to be bad. They're still going to be bad. Did you see Jay Cutler, the thing with him?
No.
Somebody asked for a picture with him, and Jay Cutler told him he had to chug an entire pitcher of beer,
mm-hmm.
and he did, and got a picture with Jay Cutler.
Good for him.
You can actually see that.
That's a lively selfie.
Absolutely. Last but not least, for the NFL, this is probably the biggest news of all last week.
I am retiring.
Yeah, right. No, J.J. Watt signs with
the
Cardinals.
And I'm entering the draft.
J.J. Watt signs with the Cardinals for a two-year deal for $31 million. And he came out at the beginning of the week saying, you know, or at the beginning of this thing when he wanted to be released, that he wants to go someplace to win a Super Bowl. And then he gets this pretty good-sized contract. Now, do you think the Arizona Cardinals are a team that could potentially win a Super Bowl, or is he just grabbing some cash?
They've got a lot of good pieces.
And they're
in place. They've got a solid foundation that really they were lacking on the defensive pass rush last year. That if you can get to guys like Russell Wilson,
mm-hmm.
you can shut down the Seahawks.
Mm-hmm. That's right. I agree 100% with you there, Jeremy. I think, and he's getting a lot of shit for this. He's getting a lot of shit for going to the Cardinals because of how he said he wants to win a Super Bowl. I don't think this is a bad spot for him to go.
He's back with D-Hop.
He's back with D-Hop, and he's got, I mean, an ever-improving quarterback in Kyler Murray.
Probably the most athletic quarterback in the NFL.
That's right. And so I don't see this as a bad move.
Only the most athletic quarterback in the NFL because Josh McCown retired.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, now
he now is. He's the most.
I waited till McCown retired before I said that.
Yeah.
And still Drew Brees has not yet announced that he's going to retire. Do you think he comes back?
No.
I don't either. Same thing with Ben Roethlisberger. He may come back too.
Oh, he'll come back.
I don't like when players do this.
I don't either.
You're holding your team hostage. They cannot move forward with whatever the next step is because you're leaving them out in fucking limbo.
Yeah.
Favre did that forever to the fucking Packers.
The Packers.
Who else did that?
The Favre with the Jets.
McCown.
Favre with the Vikings.
Vikings. McCown with the Texans.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, let's move on. Let's go to to your favorite part of every single episode, Jeremy.
Keep laughing, assholes.
No. We are out of sports.
There's got to be something. Some croquet?
No.
Some horseshoes.
No. Ooh, actually, I do. I do have a question. I do have a question for both of you.
I've got a fucking answer.
Yeah, buddy, here we go.
Shit, is this your way of getting into questions?
No.
God damn it.
No, this is not actually an actual question.
Okay.
But this is, I found this, and this came up.
Uh-huh.
Would you rather
be
the playground tetherball champion mm-hmm. or the four square champion?
Tetherball.
Really?
That's where it was fucking at when I was a kid.
Are you serious?
Yeah, we didn't even have Foursquare.
We thought those fuckers standing by the tetherball, they were like losers.
Fuck no. When that thing comes going around a million miles an hour,
no.
Right at your fucking head.
No. I was too short. I couldn't hit it anyway. I always played against those guys that were like really, really tall, and they would just kind of hit it down a little bit so it would just go over me.
Those tetherball guys got all the puss, man.
What?
Oh, yeah. They were pulling puss really? Left and right.
No.
Yeah.
Foursquare, man. No shoe shiners?
Really? I mean,
no mega bombs?
Back when I was in high school, we had an old saying, four square, three holes. That's the way it worked. That's how you got ladies if the four square was where it's at.
I totally was a four square guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You guys ever tried four square dancing?
No.
A lot of fun.
Nerds!
That's okay.
Douchebags.
We're fucking cool nerds. All right, so yeah, let's get into questions. Let's actually get into some. We had a lot of listener questions. Man, we had a whole bunch.
Yeah, so simmer it down on that shit, guys.
No, actually.
We're not that smart.
I think it's okay. Yeah. I think it's fine.
You could have saved someone for another episode.
No. Unfortunately, this is the time of year where there's not a lot of sports until March Madness happens.
Nice and tight, in and out.
Mm-hmm.
25 minutes. Let's be done.
No. Anyways, this is our questions and preguntas segments for all of you Hispanic people out there.
We have not yet gotten a pregunta.
No, not one.
Every pregunta test we've gotten is negative.
Yeah.
So
here's a fun fact. Never mind. I don't want to do that. Anyways, questions and preguntas.
Aborto.
There is now a Q&A link on our TikTok where you can put your questions. I would love to answer all of them. However, there is a bunch of them that are out there right now that we have already answered. So
it's a pretty weak link, though.
Huh?
Nothing.
No. Okay. But it makes it easier for us to also tag you to show that we replied to your question when we put it on TikTok.
By that, do you mean fuck them?
No.
You're going to tag them.
No. Tag and bag.
No.
Right in the ass.
It does actually make it easier for us to fuck you. So
we don't want
to. I don't know how you use the internet, Scotty, but I do it for fucking listeners.
Okay. All right. That's
right. That's the only reason I do this podcast, for the puss.
Okay.
Right in their ear pussies.
Mm-hmm.
They're weed whacked manscaped ear pussies. Okay,
so I like a Landon strip on my ear pussy.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's why I got those.
Yeah,
the weed whacker.
Oh, darn. Okay, so we're gonna get on to questions. First question.
We tried to stall it as long as we could.
Why mm-hmm. not?
Yeah,
we did.
Yeah.
Is for Zoch One. What's something that is completely legal but shouldn't be?
Karaoke.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah.
Without a license.
That was the worst fucking experience of my life, was working in a karaoke bar for 5 years.
Do you think, what should the law be? No karaoke at all, or you have to be below 200 pounds?
No karaoke ever.
Okay, it was actually.
Oh, there's some fat girls who can belt it out.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, look at what Adele was able to do before she mm-hmm. lost all the weight.
Nah, mm-hmm. yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah,
a lot of shitty relationships. That's what.
Yeah, I just don't want to hear Five Sisters, Eight Beers Deep, sing "We're Family."
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
I hear you, man. All right, Jeremy, what's something that is completely legal but shouldn't be?
You can wear a clown costume anywhere, into any store, into any place of business. They cannot legally kick you out for wearing a clown costume, providing you're wearing a mask.
Okay, fair enough.
Mm-hmm.
I've got one. Mine is going 35 in the fast lane. If you are getting on the highway to get onto the highway, the on-ramp, and you are not at least accelerating to the highway speed, fuck mm-hmm. you. Like cops start shooting out your tires and shit like that. That's what I'm into.
Okay.
All right.
Destruction.
The other thing, one thing that I did think of, that a veterinarian can actually do medical procedures on people if they don't charge them for it. Seems odd, but that it's a profit thing. Because we can't tax it then.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's legal. Why not?
Yeah. All right. Next question. Whitney Cox, 00. What's the funniest prank you have ever pulled on somebody?
I've got a couple to the same guy.
No fucking way.
One, I took about 10 pounds or 10 bags of the aluminum foil glitter,
mm-hmm.
27 boxes of tinsel, and decorated his front yard.
Oh, that sucks.
He mowed 3 times and then called to tell me that that is goddamn vandalism. Because his yard still shimmered. Same guy. It was in February at this point. We used to work the same job together. So I had my old uniform, and I went and bought some pillows and ripped all the stuffing out and stuffed it completely full. Made a complete dead body. Stabbed it in the back, dumped tomato juice on it, put an empty bottle of Jaeger in its hand face down, caution taped off his front yard. And
oh my God.
I got pictures. He gets out of... He gets up. He had to work at 4:30 in the morning, and it had snowed that night. So he didn't even realize, like, he didn't have time to clean his car off or anything. So he just drug it over to the tree and left. And his wife got up and thought it was him because it was his uniform.
Oh, my God.
And she just left it there after she realized what was going on. She was freaked out and went out there and then realized it was what it was. And she said that, that whole day she watched cars just slowly drive up and down the street.
Oh, God, that's brutal, man.
Mm-hmm.
Man, and mine's like lighthearted. I had we installed one of those air horns under some guy that we work with. I mean, whenever he sat down and pushed the button to the air horn, mm-hmm. he damn near had a heart attack, though, whenever he fucking sat down. It was pretty funny, and I got video evidence of that one. How about you, Jeremy?
In high school, you know, being out in the fucking country like we were, we used to have these, like, keg parties out in the middle of fucking nowhere, just, you know, whoever got whatever beer they could find and
yeah,
just go out in the country and have these big get-togethers. And this friend of mine was very, very drunk and stumbling around to where he didn't really know where he was and sat in the driver's side of my car and passed out there. And so I tried to wake him up, and he wouldn't wake up. He just kind of... So I grabbed his keys out of his pocket, went and got his car, pulled it around in front of my car, and then just all of a sudden flipped on the headlights and honked on the horn. And he wakes up realizing he's behind the wheel of a fucking car with headlights coming at him and just, like, fucking just about jerked my steering wheel off the fucking dashboard.
Fucking perfect. Mm-hmm. That's what you get, man.
Yeah.
That is what you get.
We're not friends anymore.
Yeah. Okay. Next question. Because he
fucked my wife, but still, you know.
Oh, man.
Poorly. I was watching the whole time. I'm like, do better.
Come on. All right. Here you go. Reichenfrost. Blank. The rejected Lego set.
There's not many of them if you listen to this show.
Right?
Yeah, that's true.
Quite a few. I don't know if you're... how familiar you are with early American history, but I would go with H.H. Holmes' Murder Castle. America's first serial killer. He was very wealthy, set up basically a hotel where people would come, usually single women, where he would then seal you in your room and gas you and watch you die.
Yep.
And then burn your body in the basement. And Legos, you know, they had the incinerator and everything.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It was just, it was a fucking cigarette lighter.
Yeah.
But that'll melt a Lego.
Yeah, it will.
Sure will.
Let's see.
Get you to smoke.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to go with the 9/11 Lego set.
You fucker.
Oh, did I take yours?
Mm-hmm, that's okay. Oh,
damn. We're just on the same wavelength.
No, we're not.
Yeah, we are. I'm good with that. 9/11 with both towers and planes.
Comes fully assembled.
Yep.
And then you just have to disassemble it.
That's right. Very quickly.
Little remote control planes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
I guess I could say, even though I've already said it on the show, but Auschwitz.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
Yeah.
For sure.
You know, very, very, very skinny Lego people. Like, lots of them.
Yeah.
And then little working chambers. And
oh, yeah. Absolutely.
On the 9/11 one, you could actually just put little, like, firecrackers in there as explosives, like what the fucking government did when they faked that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Man. Anyways, let's see. Next one. Casey Davis, 3407. Something that should never be used during foreplay.
Potato peeler. Nothing good can come from that, no matter which end you're using.
All right. Saying. How about you, Derek?
Your son's Hot Wheels? Why? Just imagine it's getting real hot and heavy. And then here's this little toy car, and you're just going over your wife's tits, just.
Oh, fuck. You know, Scotty's sister's puss is like a parking garage for Hot Wheels. You've seen what she can do with ping pong balls. Watch her fucking shoot out cars.
Looks like a drag strip.
She calls it valet parking. It's fucking weird. But you don't got to tip her.
Man. I went with a taser. I don't think that would be.
I thought that turned you on.
No, man. I don't think that would be very fun. I mean,
that's the only way I can get an erection.
I mean, it could. But I wouldn't recommend that. I think that'd be bad. Next one. Here we go. Baxter_97. Name something you shouldn't tell your friends. I'm sorry. Hold on. You shouldn't yell. I'm going to do this again. Name something you shouldn't yell at your friend's gender reveal party.
I'm going to go with a hypothetical.
Okay.
Say that it's going to be a boy.
Yeah.
And you accidentally realize you got the wrong color. And like right when they're getting ready to pop it off, don't run out and go, abort mission, abort mission.
Oh, that's bad. How about you, Jeremy?
Yeah, whenever you see either the pink or the blue puff, just be like, I can't believe one of them wasn't black. Oh. Or who's the father? When are they going to reveal that?
Yep. I put, he fucked that shit.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I went with or that one. Feel how smooth my balls are. Manscaped.
Yeah. All right. I am going to try to pronounce this and I promise I'm trying. But I'm going to go with Kazmarek.Brock.Blank. Rejected names for a meat market.
Cream pies.
Okay. How about you, Derek?
I can't believe it's not taint.
Oh, man.
What'd you think you got? It tastes just like taint.
That's bad.
Wait a minute. Are we talking about like a singles bar meat market or like a butcher shop?
I was going with a butcher shop.
Okay, yeah. I was going a singles bar.
Well, cream pies is still a butcher shop.
Sure.
I went with vegan nightmares. That's mine.
Okay.
Did you hear the vegan teacher got kicked off of TikTok?
Good.
Yeah.
I didn't even know there was one. No, I shouldn't say that.
Oh, you okay.
I mean, free speech is free speech.
Yeah, okay. I agree with that. All right, so...
But next. Good.
Yeah, but good. Good riddance. 1998 Chevy S10. Worst names for a children's hospital.
Could this guy have picked a more specific, dull fucking vehicle? You didn't go with Corvette?
No. Or
Testarossa? Chevy S10. 1998 Chevy S10.
Yeah.
He could extended cab.
Yeah. Could have been 1992 Ford Taurus. That's going to be my new TikTok name now.
It's a Chevy S10 two-wheel drive.
Why? What? What? Come on.
Okay. What's this question again? I can't get past the name.
Let's see. Worst names for a children's hospital.
The Ruby Ridge Memorial Hospital.
I went with early endings.
Okay.
That's mine.
Terminal World.
Oh. Our Lady of Merciful Killings.
Oh, man. Oh, God. That's fucked up. That's awful. God damn it.
Jack Kevorkian Memorial Hospital.
Oh, fuck.
Or the Rick Rude Memorial Hospital, just because I think he should have a hospital named after him.
Look at that body.
I'm here to tell all you fat, sweaty
kids.
Out of shape, obese children.
Let me take off my robe and show you what a real man looks like.
And have some hot cancer 4-year-old girl come take his robe off of him.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's so terrible.
That's fucking awful.
Rick Rude should not do that.
No. Oh man. Okay.
I like to think it's a 4-year-old Rick Rude
doing right. Okay, Sam_Lucas, if you could add "you piece of shit" at the end of any famous movie quote, what would it be?
You had me at hello. Okay. Because that would really create some confusion. Is she taking me back or not?
Yeah.
You had me at hello, you piece of shit.
Okay, Derek?
Hakuna Matata, you piece of shit. It means no worries, you piece of shit. Wait, does that guy like me? I said it means no worries, you piece of shit.
This is great. Mine is bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Probably. It really is. I can only think of I am your father, you piece of shit. From Darth Vader. Mm-hmm.
That was actually your father.
Yeah, probably.
He actually says that.
No, he totally does. Okay. All right. Next one. No Bones 27. If you were in prison, what would your prison name be?
Bitch.
Yeah.
I wouldn't make it.
Fuck no. I don't know why we're thinking of names for this, because I'd be dead very quickly.
I'd be like stirring a can of paint by the time they were done with me.
Oh, God.
I don't know. I like to think that there'd be some tough fucking prisoner out there who would protect you so you'd edit his podcast.
Hang on to his pocket.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Okay. All right. Next
what
one.
What was Jeremy's?
No. Oh, wasn't that yours?
No.
Oh, what is yours?
Steve.
Okay. Fair Go enough. On. Let's see. The next big reality show, America's Got Blank.
COVID.
Yeah.
Because that's what it is that's right now.
What it is. Who's got it? How about you, Jeremy?
Shingles. Just showing off your rash.
Yep.
Wherever it is.
Yep.
And then people judging it.
Yep.
One asshole. That's the worst, the ugliest rash I've ever seen. That is pathetic.
Yep. Depression.
Uh huh.
Yep. And that's valid.
Mm hmm.
Okay. Next one. Let's see. A less scary movie title for the movie Jaws.
Angry Flipper.
God damn. Literally, I put Angry Fishy.
Yeah. I guess that's really more an accurate term. Flipper was a dolphin.
Right.
They're not fish.
No. And sharks are fish.
They sure are.
You fucking correct your shit, Jeremy.
I just did.
Okay.
I'm the one who fucking pointed it out.
Say I was right. Do it. Do it.
You weren't right.
Come on.
I can do this all fucking day. I can sit here not talking as long as you want me to.
Damn it. How about you, Derek?
One more time.
I'll say a less scary movie title for the movie Jaws.
Oh. Fishy, fishy, fishy.
Fishy, fishy.
Okay, let's see. Oh, here you go. A bad thing to hear after yelling hello into a deep cave. Jeremy?
We can lower the interest rate on your credit cards.
Yeah.
Because that's what happens when I say hello into my phone most of the fucking time.
Yeah. Yeah. Derek?
Hello?
Do you have a second to talk about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ? Yeah. Oh, Jesus. I got 10 minutes will save you 10% on car insurance. A good name for a Christian water park.
Sacrifice Cove. Instead of diving boards, they got crucifixes. They just hang you from them and then you fall over.
It's fucking awful.
Sure is, Scotty. It's a sacrifice.
Yeah,
it's not supposed to be pleasant.
Yeah.
As is the Christian way.
Yeah. I got God's golden showers. That's mine. Okay. How about you, Derek?
One Piece World. I don't think they're going to be seeing much skin.
Yeah. So those old style 1920s covers the arms and legs.
Yeah.
Totally. Put that bathing cap back on.
Yes, that's right. No hair. Put on a turtleneck.
Oh, man. That's bad. Okay, next one. What makes hobos so sexy?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Where do I start? First off, they'll do anything for a can of pork and beans. Anything. Yeah. They'll put that can wherever you want it.
Okay.
They're also very unwilling to call law enforcement, which I find a super sexy quality in anybody.
Okay.
And I like trains. So. You call them hobos or vagrants. I call them world travelers.
Okay. I put mo money, mo problems. No money, no problems. That's okay. What, I mean, that's the way I roll. How about you there, Derek?
Well, first off, the smell.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I mean, there's just something about a natural musk.
Yes, hobos do not use ball deodorant.
No, they don't. Mm-hmm.
No, that's the only part where it goes a little south.
Or deodorant at all.
And that the fact that they do live on trains, that they're not going to be sticking around after a while.
Yeah.
They're not just going to move all their shit in.
Yeah.
Oh, and if
yeah.
they do, it's a knapsack. Mm-hmm. Pretty easy to put away.
Every time I see a hobo, I'm like, that's a nice caboose.
Okay.
Back of the train's not bad either.
Yep. Okay. All right.
Tell me you wouldn't fuck a hobo, Scotty.
I wouldn't. I definitely, definitely would not.
I think you mean couldn't.
Probably.
You ain't got hobo type game.
No, I don't. I'm out on the hobos.
You try to seduce a hobo and he's going to turn you down 9 times out of 10.
Right.
Unless you get one who's really drunk on cooking sherry.
Okay. Right on. Let's do one we got from, oh, damn it. I didn't write his name down. Fuck. I can't do that one. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Next, I think this may be the last one. A rejected crayon color.
Infection green.
Okay.
Just whatever the color of disease pus is.
Oh, that's gross.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, it is. Fuck yeah, it is.
I went with bowel movement brown.
Okay.
Yeah. Derek?
Honky white.
Oh, man.
There's different shades of honky white. Mm-hmm. There's Irish honky white.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the whitest white.
It doesn't get any whiter than that.
With just a tinge of red.
Yeah.
That's almost clear.
Yeah. And it's drunk.
There's Texas honky white.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a little bit browner.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
A little bit more tan.
Yep.
Gotcha.
And then there's, I've been out in the sun too long, honky white, which is just red.
If you mix honky white, Irish honky white and Texas honky white, you get Carlos O'Kelly's. So,
shit. I wasn't going to do this one. Kind of want to, though. Let's do one more. One more question.
Jesus.
Okay. I'm going to go where this question is. Rejected names for hot dogs.
Meat marshmallows.
Okay. Do you have anything?
Meat swords, I guess.
Yeah, okay, that's pretty good. I've got nothing. I just set you guys up with that one just because I had nothing.
Great.
Okay, this is the end of our question segment, guys. If you do have any good questions, do us a favor. Send them to our TikTok account under the Q&A. That's how we see those. And if they're any good, we'll put them on the show and give you a shout-out. So thank you to all of those of you that did that. We really do appreciate it. Keep on doing it. Helps us out. And now, we get to move on to the draft. Ready for this?
Sure.
I got dead ready. Dead fucking last.
This may have been the worst ass whipping ever in the history of this draft.
On me.
On just, I mean, as far as margin of victory.
Yeah.
At all.
You won.
Yes. By a fucking landslide.
Because you didn't want to pick two cars that are the same. You didn't want to pick two of the same car.
Right. And yet I still got them both.
And you got them both. And because you got them both, you fucking killed us.
I think I'd have won just with General Lee. That's got to be the most iconic car.
I don't necessarily think so.
Well, you're fucking wrong.
Well, I must be, apparently.
It's bright orange with a Confederate flag. Is there anything that sticks out more right now?
Yeah, true.
course, that burnt orange is actually kind of an in look on certain cars.
Yeah.
I don't care for it.
Derek took second, and I...
with 12.
Yeah. And I
had 158 or some shit. It was... It was close to triple digits anyway.
Yeah, I got the dead last. So I get first pick today, gentlemen, and I'm going to fucking need it after that absolutely awful performance of last week. So, ladies and gentlemen, this week's draft is going to be our favorite SNL alumni, our favorite Saturday Night Live actors and actresses. Oh,
fuck. You said SNL. I was going to Snails.
Oh
shit! My list is all fucked up.
I'm perfectly okay with that. After the ass whooping you put on us, we need to beat you this week.
Whatever. I had 12.
You had 12. I had like 3.
Yeah, that's about normal for you.
No, thanks, man. Appreciate it. Fuck you, Derek. I've won. I won like 3 in a row.
Must have been when I was gone.
Shut up. Anyways. All right, so our best or our favorite Saturday Night Live alumni actors and actresses, I get first pick, and I'm sorry.
Dennis Miller, I know you're going to do it.
No, no, no.
Hey, Whitney Brown.
No, 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 no. I got to do it.
Finesse Mitchell.
Chris Farley.
Okay.
I'm sorry, he's my favorite of all time, and I wish he was still with us. And now we get to go to the D.
You always go to the D, Scotty.
Nope, you.
I'm going to go with Will Ferrell.
Mm. Are you fucking serious?
Oh, dude, yeah. Without a doubt.
I guess I'm definitely weird when it comes to
You're
this.
You're fucking definitely weird.
I don't find him very funny other than the Jeopardy skits. Everything else I'm not a fan of.
Okay.
And his movies. I mean, Step Brothers was funny, but other than that, Anchorman, not my thing.
Like Talladega Nights?
Talladega Nights. My cousin's in that movie, and I still didn't really like it all that much.
No, well, that's probably because your cousin doesn't like you.
No, yeah, okay.
All right.
He's the asshole. He's the bad guy.
Sure.
Denton, isn't that his name? That owns the race car people? Yeah. That's married to Molly Shannon?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's my second cousin.
No, so. I hate that movie.
He should.
Mm-hmm.
He's a cool guy, though.
All right,
Jeremy. All right, Jeremy, go.
John Belushi.
Yeah. That's a good one, man.
That's where I was going to go.
And then... Phil Hartman.
Okay. Fuck,
I like that one, too.
I know I skipped a big one, but I'm going to do it anyway.
Okay. Okay.
Me?
Yep.
Mike Myers.
Yeah, damn it. That's another good one, you fuckers.
Yeah, that's what we're supposed to do, Scotty.
I know.
Tim Kazurinsky.
Tom Davis.
Luckily, I get 2.
Robert Downey Jr.
He's on there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he was...
Which I can't remember. That surprised the shit out of me.
That was in the horrible years that had an outstanding cast.
So
that you would have thought was just amazing.
I'm going to go with Norm MacDonald.
Okay.
And then damn it. Damn it. He was so good on Saturday Night Live. I'm going to go Dana Carvey.
Mm-hmm. That was the big one I skipped. Next to Will Ferrell, probably the quintessential
Saturday Night Live
Saturday guy. Night Live guy.
Yeah, I agree. Okay, go dickhead.
Bill Murray.
Yeah, that's another one that was good. But he wasn't on there for very long, was he?
3 years.
3 years?
Yeah.
Really? Wow.
Yeah. He took over. Chevy Chase wasn't on for very long.
Yeah.
And Bill Murray took over at the very end of the first season for him.
Damn it. That's just rough. Okay. All right. Jeremy, you get 2, dude.
Okay. Fuck me. Eddie Murphy.
Yeah, that's a big one.
And he fell off the fucking map, but I'm going to still go with him. Joe Piscopo.
Ooh. I wasn't really a big fan of him, though. All right, Derek.
You never saw Johnny Dangerously?
Yeah.
It's a great movie.
Okay.
He's in it.
It's subjective, Jeremy. All right, Derek, what do you got?
I'm going to go with Sandler.
Yeah.
Adam?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, Steve.
Steve Sandler.
Yeah. I'm going to take Adam Sandler then. he wasn't on for very long, but I got to take, he's one of my favorites. I'll take Chris Rock.
Yeah.
So.
Really?
Yeah. I really do
like him. He was, just never did anything good on the show.
No, nope. That's what he did afterwards, though.
Well, yeah, I mean, if we're going with that,
shut up, Christ. Shut up. What do you got, Derek? Oh, no, I get one more. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm sorry. I missed it. I don't want to pick that guy.
Don't.
No, kind of have to. Yeah, I'm gonna pick Chevy Chase.
Even though the half season he was on, huh?
Yeah, I know. But he was on there. That'll make my stepdad happy. That's the whole thing.
Okay.
That's who he loves. That's his favorite.
Okay.
All right, Derek, end it.
a current cast member, actually. Kate McKinnon.
She's very funny.
She's fucking hysterical.
Okay. Way to make the show not appear to be sexist. We appreciate that.
She's funny as shit, man. Those alien abduction videos.
Oh, Jesus, yeah.
That might be one of the best skits of all time.
Jeremy, last pick, dude. What do you got?
Going with the legend, Dan Aykroyd. Yeah,
that was the one I was kind of picking back and forth, but I took Chevy Chase.
I'm surprised you didn't go with David Spade since you had Farley.
No, I really liked David Spade, but Chris Farley made David Spade.
Well, and yeah, that was in the movies. On Saturday Night Live, Spade had his little, well, he had the bye-bye.
Yeah.
That, which got real fucking old.
Mm-hmm. Immediately. You can watch one of those and then it gets old.
But his snarky segments on the news.
Yeah.
But other than that, usually he was just the white guy.
Yeah. The token guy. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of surprised. I'm glad that none of us picked Fallon.
No.
I wasn't a fan. I really wouldn't. Any more now than he does at the Tonight Show, I'm kind of falling out of love with him.
Oh, Jesus. That show's fucking awful compared to the Carson would fucking roll over in his grave if he was.
Bill Hader would have been a good pick.
Yeah, I had Hader on my list.
Tracy Morgan. Pick.
I had Tracy Morgan on my list.
Sandberg would have been good. Andy Sandberg.
I was never a big fan of him.
I love those digital shows.
I like Davidson, but nobody really knows who he is.
What about John Lovitz? Did anybody like him at all?
He was, okay, in the early 80s, or maybe more mid-80s, when, God damn it, what's the guy's name? Lorne Michaels.
Mm-hmm.
When he left the show for a little while, and the other guy took over, they had this fucking cast of, you would think it was the best cast ever. Mm-hmm. There was Robert Downey Jr. There was Randy Quaid.
Oh, wow.
There was Julia Louis-Dreyfus. I mean, just these fucking legendary comedic actors. But the writing and the producing of it was shit.
Kind of like it is now.
And then Lorne Michaels came back and got some like more veteran comedians. He got Martin Short, Billy Crystal.
Mm-hmm.
Billy
Crystal wasn't on for very long, though, was he?
No, but he did that Fernando's Hideaway.
Yeah.
And that was his big one.
I can't remember his fucking name. I liked him, though. He was just kind of weird, looked kind of goofy, but he did Night at the Roxbury with Will Ferrell.
Chris Kattan.
Chris Kattan, that's who I was thinking of.
He didn't have a lot of good sketches, though.
No.
He had that Mr. Peepers.
Yeah, yeah.
And usually that was about it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, guys, that is our draft this week. I will put the draft up on Facebook Wednesday. It should be up by noon where you can go and with the corresponding emoji, you can vote for your favorite list of what we selected and also comment which ones you would have picked, but don't be an asshole about it because we didn't pick what you wanted doesn't mean you got to be a jerk off. Why didn't you pick this guy?
Yeah.
And I find so many of them when they do that, they obviously haven't listened to the episode because a lot of the people that you put down there, we give honorable mentions at the end of our selections.
Sure.
So.
Yeah, we're allowed a total of 15, and there have actually, this is a little known fact, there's been over 148,000 cast members on Saturday Night Live.
Yeah.
That show is actually older than I am.
Yeah, and it's true. So anyways, look for that tomorrow, but now we get to move on to my favorite segment of every single episode. This is what we like to call the Laughing on the Sidelines Shitty Situation of the Week. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is this week's shitty situation brought to you by Fangerbang Beer.
Damn right.
And Legos.
Enjoy that cold, refreshing one. You know, I was actually telling you guys off the air, and I'll tell the fans a little bit more about it. At the 1955 24 Hours of Le Mans, driver who was driving for Mercedes was forced off of the road. Parts of his car, it killed him and parts of his car went into the crowd, killing 83 spectators and injuring 180 more.
Oh, my God.
And your child can recreate that moment in still time as the bodies are being decapitated with Legos.
Good old Legos.
Unleash the imagination.
That's right. Man, they just won't, they really don't have one that's rejected idea, do they?
They don't.
I know.
They'll put anything. You can, I mean.
They're the Disney movies of toys.
It may not be what's on the box, but you can make it. You can combine kits together and make it.
In fact, all of our ideas for rejected Legos kits are actually going to be in production later as well. So
sure they are.
Anyways.
All right. Well, we'll put some Legos in baggies and just kind of tell you to make it.
Yeah. Because that's what creative people actually
instructions.
Fucking do.
Put the instructions. Snap bricks together. I'll, that's it.
I'll send you a picture of the aftermath of that accident.
And you recreate
and
it.
And you recreate it.
That's right. Okay. So this week's shitty situation is going to be partially... I give a little bit of credit to Anthony Reinhardt. We're going to take one of his options because we've just beaten Cardi B to the fucking ground.
I just wish we'd just bury her the rest of the way.
Nah, I'd actually like to bury her from the neck down and just watch like birds and stuff peck at her for a while.
Because she'd still talk. I'd like to maybe feet up so I could see her fucking legs kicking and she struggles for her last breath.
That's awful.
I'd like to do it like on the shore.
Uh-huh.
And as the tide just rises... slowly, yeah. And just to hear the screams of terror.
Oh, that's
you can recreate that with Legos too.
Okay, but we're gonna use shitty situation. Jeremy, what do we got, buddy?
The fuck should I know?
I don't know.
God damn,
you're the one.
You put me on the spot here.
I know. Every week, same shit.
Every goddamn week.
Yep.
All right. It's pretty simple, really.
Yep.
Would you rather be tased while having sex or jerk off with 60 grit sandpaper?
Oh, man.
You know, there was a guy that I saw on TikTok that talked about tasing during sex.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Said that the girl that he dated, they were kind of freaky and they wanted to try that. And he said that she was bent over the bed and he was standing behind her grounded.
Mm-hmm.
If you will, and he tased her, and it shot through his fucking dick and balls.
Mm-hmm.
He said it felt like the God of Thunder himself it was taking his hammer to town down there.
The rules of electricity do not change just because you're fucking.
Yeah, so I'm going to go just based off of his description of that. I'll take the sandpaper.
Oh, my God, are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I can come quick. So, I mean, it's going to be like four strokes max.
Oh, my God. No, I don't think so. I'm taking the Thor Thunder whatever. I'm sorry. I can just imagine how scarred up my member would be.
Even more than now.
Even more than now.
You can't fuck fire, Scotty. You should have learned that.
Yeah, I know.
Don't stick your dick in fire.
No.
Or do.
Whatever. Yeah. Whatever you want. Do whatever you want, man.
Free fucking country.
Exactly. No, I am going to do the taser. I cannot imagine the sandpaper. God damn it. That just would fucking hurt.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm out. I'm going to do the taser.
Yeah. What people may not know about sandpaper is the lower the number, the grittier it is.
Oh.
60 is real fucking gritty. this project I'm on, I'm using 220 to make it nice and smooth. Yeah. This is what you would do like if you want to shape a log. And while I'm sure getting tased during sex would hurt, it would make me move faster than I've ever moved. At least since my marriage. And she might think that I actually am into it.
Yeah.
And once we clean the piss and shit off the floor, it's done with. There's no permanent marks.
I don't know. You might lose. You're going to flip a breaker. You know what I mean? Not even plugged into a circuit.
I might start to like it. Who knows? And then we're having to pay for taser charging all the fucking time.
Yeah.
Electricity bill goes way up. Mm-hmm. Even when we're not having sex. And she's like, you've been jerking it again? You really got to cut down on that.
Yeah.
I can't stop.
Well, for the very few times.
So taser.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But that's our shitty situation of the week. But this very rarely happens. But in times where there's not a lot of sports to talk about, we are under time. We've mm-hmm. got some time left. And there was a trend that's going around on TikTok that I kind of am tired of because they're all a bunch of bullshit questions. So we're going to make our...
That's what we do.
Yeah. So
answer a bunch of bullshit questions.
Yeah. So... we're going to do our own and see if you like it. But this is the Tell Me Without Telling Me challenge. Mm-hmm. And Derek, this week's Tell Me Without Telling Me challenge, what do we got?
I don't know. What is it?
That's yours.
It is?
Yeah. What do you got?
Okay. Shit. Tell me you're addicted to porno without telling me you're addicted to porno.
Done deal. Got mine.
Mm-hmm.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right. Mine is check your phone, your history. It's always blank. That's how you know. Derek?
I went to a bank and I saw an ATM machine and the words ATM were right on the machine and cash was the second thing that came to mind.
Very good. Jeremy?
Our electricity bill keeps going up. We're also, yeah, I would let you borrow my phone, but I only got like 2% left. Battery, it's about out.
Yeah. There you go. There is our Tell Me Without Telling Me challenge of the week, because I may start doing this if we have extra time. But that is all we got for this week's episode, gentlemen, unless you guys have any dates or anything fun to share.
I would like to start a movement on TikTok, not a bow.
Okay.
Actual legit movement. Okay. Something that I've had a problem with. There's the what's a video that lives in your head rent free?
Yeah.
I would like to have that banned from TikTok. If we could all start a petition, because videos don't pay rent.
Yeah.
Why can't it just be in your head? Why has it got to be rent-free? What videos are you charging rent to, you fucking bitch?
The ones we're addicted to?
She looks like Blossom. Have you noticed that? She looks like Mayim Bialik.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, did you see on the Peacock, they're bringing back Punky Brewster?
On the what?
The Peacock, the NBC streaming app.
Oh, okay. No.
Yeah, because now having cable isn't enough. Now you got to pay extra to stream all their fucking content that isn't on the normal
channels. You can get it for free if you're willing to put up with 1,000 hours of commercials.
Oh, that's...
Which I don't get it for free.
Right. Or,
I mean, I do get it for free. I'm willing to put up with it. And I'm not going to watch Punky Brewster.
No?
No. She was kind of a hot box of rocks. Who was it? That was Soleil Moonfry.
Yeah.
That played her.
I'm excited they're making a new Beavis and Butthead movie.
What?
Are they really?
Mm-hmm. On Paramount Plus. That's another streaming fucking site.
Oh, but, Jesus. Yeah. It's all it's getting to. Subscriptions to
Well, they got to close the movie theaters. So,
sure.
Movies are all coming out on streaming apps. Mm-hmm. HBO Max... see, at the end of the month, they're doing the Godzilla versus Kong. Can't wait for that one. Scare mm-hmm. the shit out of my wife.
Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, they're coming out with a new one of those.
And Coming to America 2 comes out this month.
Oh, boy. I'm not going to watch that.
I will watch it.
I'm not.
The first one was so good, and this can't be anything but bad.
Yeah, I agree.
It just... But it's nice to see Arsenio getting some work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But this is going to be like the equal to Bad Boys 3.
Mm-hmm.
This is what it's going to be.
Never watch Bad Boys 3.
That's because it's that much of a pile of shit.
I mean, the whole point of it is, you know, what is it? He's got a son in America now, I found out.
He's mm-hmm. got a son. Will Smith has a son.
You mean Eddie Murphy?
No. Talking about
I'm talking about Coming to America.
Well, he's talking about Coming to America.
Not Bad Boys. That's the whole reason he found out he's got a son, which that movie is what, 30 years old?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he don't need you at this point. All you're going to do is come in and fuck up his life.
I just hope they have Randy Watson.
Okay. Yeah.
I love him.
All right.
He's in the previews anyway.
Yeah.
Very bloated.
Oh, well, that's great.
That boy good.
Yeah. He can sing.
That boy good.
Yeah. I was talking about Bad Boys 3. I was going to give you the whole idea about it, but it's not even worth it.
No.
It's not.
No. Will Smith, what was the last good Will Smith movie? Because that...
7 Pounds or The Pursuit of Happiness.
Pursuit of Happiness was good. 7 Pounds was sad as fuck.
It was good, though.
It was good, but it was sad as fuck.
I've never seen that, and I don't know what it's about.
Don't.
Is it heroin?
No.
Is that...
Yeah,
no. Usually they go kilos.
Smuggles it inside his asshole.
Yeah. Wow.
Across the border.
No.
Go watch The Mule, but not with Clint Eastwood. Watch the other one. That is great. My buddy told me. I tell you that story?
Yeah.
Oh, you still, if you have not watched that, or Velocipaster.
What? Wait a minute. The Mule, is that the one that kicks field goals?
No.
That's a great movie.
Velocipaster.
What the fuck?
It's a guy that turns into a dinosaur and kills ninjas. It is fucking amazing.
This can't be real.
This is real. I saw it on Amazon Prime about 5 or 6 months ago, and it was glorious.
Jesus Christ, I'm hearing about this movie now. Scotty, you got a taser?
Yeah, no shit.
Holy fuck, everything about that movie sounds amazing.
Yeah. It is great.
It's got everything you want. You've got
special effects are there.
Uh-huh. Is it like one of those shitty sci-fi?
Oh yeah.
Movie. I mean, like on Sci-Fi Channel where they make their own, like with Sharknado.
Oh yeah. It's but it looks like a guy made it in college.
My favorite one of those is Piranaconda. It's like an anaconda, but a piranha.
My buddy told me there's a good one called Thanksgiving too, and it's about.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's just dumb. These are all dumb.
Patton Oswalt talks about, you can IMDb it. It's a real movie. What is it? It's a bed that rapes you or something like that. It's called like Rape Bed, the bed with a subtitle, The Bed That Rapes People.
That's so fucking stupid.
Somebody made it.
Oh, well, you know. Some people have really stupid-ass ideas for movies. All right.
I think that's a Stephen King movie.
Probably.
All right.
It's one of his short stories, one of the Bachman books.
Mm-hmm. Right. So you guys have any announcements, anything coming up that you want to talk about at all?
Not yet.
Got a big cat.
All right. Good for you there, Jeremy. Mm-hmm. All right, guys.
And it lives in my head rent-free.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, guys, thank you guys so much for doing what you do. Always keep following us and tell your friends to follow us. That's always important. Keep on sharing our stuff on TikTok. That helps us grow. We continue to grow. And we're definitely growers, not showers, and we appreciate everything that you guys do for us. As we always say, do us a favor. If you like us, tell your friends. But if you don't like us...
We hope a gypsy puts a curse on you and your eyelashes turn to pubic hair.
Oh, God. If you don't like us...
Tell your enemies.
And until next time...
Oh, yeah!
Until next time...
Keep laughing, assholes.
We will see you later, guys. Take care.